Hi, fifth grade, Miss Yosef here. I hope you all had a great weekend and are ready to get started with math class. In today's lesson, we're going to be learning about how to use equivalency to find the sum of different mixed numbers and of different fractions. If you remember from a few weeks ago, the word sum means finding the answer to an addition problem. So what we're really doing in today's lesson is adding different mixed numbers and adding different fractions with each other to find the sum. For today's fluency, we're going to start by changing a mixed number to an improper fraction. In your math packet, on any blank piece of paper, I'd like you to do the following problems. Take about a minute or so. I'm going to do the first one with you, the one to the very left, the 4 2/3. So to change a mixed number to an improper fraction, I take the denominator and multiply it by the whole number. In this case, that 3, the denominator is multiplied by the 4, that makes 12. And after that, I take that product and add it to the numerator. In this case, I would take the 12 and add it to the 2. And then I get 14, and my improper fraction now becomes 14/3. Do the remaining problems. I'm going to start putting up the answers on the screen in about a minute. I'd like you to check your work at that time. Our next fluency section is equivalent fractions. Equivalent fractions is an important skill that we need to practice before beginning our addition of fractions. If you recall from our equivalent fraction lesson quite a while ago, you're changing one fraction to another fraction by multiplying by the same factor, a numerator and your denominator. I'm going to do the one to the very left with you before you do the remaining ones by yourself. So in this one to the left, 1/2 equals how many fourths? Well, I look at the denominator 2. From 2 to become to a 4, I multiply it by a factor of 2. And that means I need to multiply the numerator by the same factor of 2 such that I get 2/4. And I know that this 2/4 is equivalent to 1/2. I can check that work by simplifying 2/4, and 2/4 simplified does become 1/2. Take a little less than a minute to do the remaining problems. In that time, like the other fluency section, I'm going to put up the answers on the screen and I'd like you to check your work as you go. All right, let's begin our concept development. I'd like you to follow along with these problems on a blank piece of paper. The first problem we're going to work on is a third plus a half. And the very first thing I want you to notice with any fractions like these is that the denominators are not the same. If the denominators are not the same, we can't just add them. The first thing we need to do is find a common denominator. The reason that is because right now, different denominators are like different units. For example, apples and oranges, cats and dogs. You can't add them unless they're like units. So to find a common denominator, which is our first step, what I need to do is first list all of the multiples that I know, not all, but some of the multiples that I know of those denominators. Remember, our denominators in this case are 3 and 2. So I would list the multiples of 3 and of 2. If I skip count by my 3s, skip count with me, I have 3, 6, 3, 6, 9, 12. I'll list those. Then I list the multiples of 2, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12. I'll list all of those. Now, the next thing you need to do is find a common multiple that both 3 and 2, the denominators, have. I notice that 6 is common between the 3 and the 2, but I also notice that 12 is common between the 3 and the 2. So, which one do I pick? Well, you always pick the lowest common multiple. In this case, you would not pick the 12, you would pick the 6. And that 6 now becomes our new common denominator for both the 1/3 and the 1/2. And to change them to those common denominators, what I need to do is find equivalent fractions. Now you have to think back to what we did in fluency. We found equivalent fractions in fluency, and that's the same thing that we're going to do here. So 1/3 is going to become a new fraction, a new equivalent fraction with 6 as a denominator. And 1/2 is going to do the same thing. It's going to be changed to an equivalent fraction with 6 as a denominator. So let's start with 1/3. The 1/3, the 3 in the denominator to become to a 6, I multiplied by 2, by a factor of 2. So to make it an equivalent fraction, I need to multiply the numerator 1 by the 2 as well. And I know that 1 times the 2 is 2. So 1/3 becomes 2/6. Let's move on to the 1/2. From the 2, the denominator of 1/2, to become a 6, the new denominator, I multiply by a factor of 3. That means I need to multiply the numerator by the same factor, and 1/2 now becomes 3/6. Now I have my new equivalent fractions. My next step is to add them, because when you go back to the original question, you're really being asked to find the sum of these two numbers or of these two fractions. Now when I add 2/6 and 3/6, I get 5/6. In the final answer, the sum of 1/3 and 1/2 equals 5/6. The main takeaway that I want you to get from this is that your denominators are not the same, so you need to find common denominators by using equivalent fractions. And when you get those equivalent fractions, then you add them. We're going to practice it on the next one. And our next problem is an 8 plus 3/4. And again, notice that our denominators are different. I have an 8 for one, and I have a 4 for another one. Remember, if they're different, the first thing that I need to do is find a common denominator by listing the multiples of the 8 and the 4. List them first and we'll go over them. For the 8, I listed 8, 16, and 24. If you went on to the 32 or other multiples, that's perfectly fine, but remember, you don't need to list all of them. A few are fine. For the 4, I listed 4, 8, 12, and 16. Now, which two multiples do you see are shared by the 8 and the 4? If you said 8 and 8 are shared, you're correct. And if you said 16 and 16 are shared, you're also correct. But I can only pick one of these. Which one should I pick? If you said 8, you are correct. And the reason we only pick the 8 and not the 16 is because we want to pick the lowest common multiple. So now 8 is going to become my new denominator. And I do that by finding equivalent fractions. So 1/8 is going to become a fraction with eighths, and 3/4 is going to become a fraction with eighths as well. I'd like you to change these. If you said an eighth remains as 1/8, you're correct. If the original fraction already has the denominator that you want, then that fraction wouldn't change, it would stay the same. Now 3/4 to become eighths. 3/4 would become 6/8 because the 4, the original denominator, to become 8, our new denominator is multiplied by a factor of 2. So I multiply the numerator 3 by a factor of 2 as well to get 6 eighths. Now my next step is to add them. I'd like you to add them, please. And the sum of 1 eighth and 6 eighths, if you said was 7 eighths, is perfectly correct. And when I go back to the original fractions, the sum of 1 eighth and 3 fourths is 7 eighths. Let's try another one. Our next one is 2 thirds plus 1 fourth. For this problem, I would like you to do all three steps independently. And I'm going to progressively put up the answers on the screen, and I'd like you to check your work as you go. Let's move on to the sum of a mixed number by a mixed number. The concept is the exact same as it was in the previous slides. The only difference now is that each of the mixed numbers has to be changed into an improper fraction. I'm going to start there. Step one, change the mixed numbers to an improper fraction. Remember from fluency when we did this, this is where it all comes together. To change the mixed number to an improper fraction, you multiply the denominator by the whole number, in this case 2 by 5, that's 10. Then add that to the numerator, that becomes 11 fifths. The 1 and 1 half, let's do that. Multiply the 2 by the 1, that's a 2. Add the 1, that becomes a 3. Now my new problem, scholars, becomes 11 fifths plus 3 halves. Let me erase all these writings here. Now step 2, our denominators are still different, but I need to find a common denominator. We're going to take this up a notch. Instead of listing all of the multiples of the 5 and all of the multiples of the 2, then finding the one they have in common, I want you to do this in your head. Think of your multiples of 5. Think of your multiples of 2. Which is the lowest one that you think they have in common? If you said 10, you're correct. That means that 11 fifths now needs to be changed to a tenth. And 3 halves also needs to be changed to tenths. Now let's look at our denominators. The 5 from 11 fifths to become to tenths needs to be multiplied by a factor of 2. 5 times 2 is 10. So that means I need to multiply 11 in the numerator by a 2. And 11 times 2 is, say it, if you said 22, you are correct. Let's do the 3 halves. The 2 from the 3 halves times 5 becomes a 10. So I need to multiply 3 by the same factor, by 5. And what is 3 times 5? If you said 15, you're correct. Now my next step is to add these equivalent fractions because that's what the original problem is asking me to do. I don't just stop there, I need to add them. So I find the sum of 22 tenths plus 15 tenths. I only add my numerators, right? The denominators stay the same because they are now the same denominator. Now 22 tenths plus 15 tenths becomes 37 tenths. Now 37 tenths, you'll notice, is an improper fraction, and we never leave our answers as an improper fraction. You can change 37 tenths to a mixed number by doing long division. 37 divided by 10 is 3. And you have a 7 as a remainder. So your new mixed number becomes 3 and 7 tenths. You can check your work. If you multiply 3 and 7 tenths the way we did in the beginning, where you do, let me get my pen, 10 times the 3, that's 30. 30 plus the 7, that's 37. 37 tenths. Our mixed number is correct. Now I'd like you to try this problem on your own. 2 and 1 fourth plus 1 and 1 fifth. Remember, every mixed number is first changed to an improper fraction, And then you have to find a common denominator by listing those multiples, but I'd like you to list those multiples in your head. And when you find the equivalent fractions, remember you have to add them. Like we did on the previous problems, I'm going to put up the answers on the screen as you're working, and I'd like you to check your work as you go. Here are two additional practice problems that I'd like you to do on a blank piece of paper. When you're finished, I would like you to text me your answers or email them to me. You can either write in the answer or you can take a picture of the work. My number is on the screen at the bottom. And I'd love to see how you're doing. And if you're correct, I'll let you know. If there's anything you need to fix, I'll help you fix it and we can move on from there. All right, great work so far for sticking with it. For today's independent practice, I'd like you to do page 15 and 16, and then I'd like you to jump all the way to page 21. On page 21 is additional practice for equivalent fractions that I'd like you to do. I really think this practice is going to help enrich your knowledge of how to find common denominators. Remember, if you have questions, you can call me, text me, or email me. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to click on the description at the bottom of this video. There will be information about this video, and there will also be additional information about different websites and practice that you can use throughout the week to help continue growing your brain. Bye, scholars. Thanks for joining.